And after weeks of battling my own internal dichotomy, I decided to click submit on my dropout form, thus plunging myself into £25,000 worth of debt. How did I let this happen, you might be wondering? Well, the story starts in 2018 when I just finished sixth form, and I was really excited to start my adult life at university. I was enrolled into computer science with artificial intelligence at the University of Nottingham, which in the UK, it's a pretty good university. Man, I was so excited to live independently and just do all the things that freshers do. But I was pretty naive and I was totally clueless about how the world worked back then. So I chose computer science because I was pretty good at it at sixth form, and to be honest, since about the age of 13, I was always that outcast kid that was the typical World of Warcraft playing PC gaming nerd. I even looked like one. Yeah, I'm disgusted, but
it is what it is.
It is what it is.
And to be honest, having went to a grammar school for sixth form and being raised in a Chinese family and being a first generation immigrant, it was kind of one of those things where university was just like the natural path of progression. And this video I'm really trying to convey to especially minority kids, like there's other kind of routes you can and should explore outside of university in order for you to make an informed decision about your future. To be honest, because I saw it as the natural path of progression, I never really questioned my decision to go to university, and I almost just went with the flow of things. Going into the first semester, I took things fairly seriously and I attended about 50% of my lectures, and I was one of those kids that considered themselves like a serious candidate. And I was super adamant that, look, I came to uni to study, I didn't spend 9.25 grand. I quickly realized that university was a complete joke and the course wasn't really challenging enough for me, especially in my first year. In the first semester, I ended up with 80% average-ish, I think probably closer to 90 actually. And I was able to do so with minimal revision, and as I said earlier, I only managed to attend 50% of my lectures. So in my second semester, I realized, wow, I was too serious in my first semester. So look, I'm just gonna kick back and have fun in my second semester. Even though, just because, you know, it doesn't count towards your final grade. What did I do? I completely stopped attending lectures and was just doing my coursework and doing the bare minimum to get by. I know, I spent 9.25 grand on that. I ended up partying a lot more frequently, and this was something that I had a lot of fun doing. But I remember vividly after every single night out, just waking up with a slight hangover and just feeling very empty on the inside. And that, to be honest, carried on for the rest of the academic year. But I mean, I still came out the year with an 86% average. I even have a YouTube video reacting to my first year's result. I'll probably link it in the top right corner. If you're interested, check that out after this video. But yeah, that was when I got my results in the summer of 2019. Looking back, for me, first year of university was a really fun way to waste time. And to be honest, that was when things kind of started to go downhill for me. So the original plan for my summer of 2019 was I had an internship lined up at a tech startup that would pay me around £2,000 a month, and I was really, really looking forward to it. I was like, wow, this is, you know, my first shot to prove myself and in a real work environment and things like that. However, it didn't pan out and they cancelled the internship literally a week before it was meant to start. Which, this left me scrambling for a job as I had literally no plans for the summer, no travel plans, no job, nothing like that. So I started going on LinkedIn and I just shotgun applied for every single job. Back then, to be honest, I didn't really know how to like kind of sell myself. So I would just go on LinkedIn and click apply, 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 apply. And a few days after, I ended up getting a call from a direct marketing company called Alpha Gamma Solutions. And they wanted me to come in for an observation day. So long story short, this was a door-to-door direct marketing company, and we would go door-to-door basically selling charity subscriptions. Essentially, during that observation day, I followed a rep around and we went around knocking doors and selling charity subscriptions. normally, you know, 9 out of 10 people would absolutely hate that experience. However, for some reason, I really, really loved it. And I genuinely thought it was the coolest thing ever. To be able to knock on someone's door and end up making money from that, I was like, wow, this is dope. I want to try this. However, little did I know just how toxic and underhanded the direct marketing industry could be. So the first few weeks, to be honest, I had a great time and I absolutely crushed it. However, I was severely overworked. You gotta understand, Monday to Saturday, I was probably on average, including commute, I was working about 12 to 16 hours a day. Now, you might be thinking, wow, this is completely illegal, and you would be entirely correct. That is if we were employees. But we were private contractors, so we were technically trading as sole traders and technically self-employed. How they got us over that hump was by saying, hey, look, you're learning how to run a business. Looking back, this is exactly what multi-level marketing programs do, and this is exactly what a pyramid scheme does, which is why, you know, hence the toxic and underhanded nature of the industry. But anyways, I digress. So to make a long story short, I ended the internship absolutely exhausted and feeling extremely burnt out. However, what the internship gave me was like this fire of wanting kind of more with life. And I became very discontent with how my life was going. Because to be honest, the experience kind of shifted my reality into a whole new different paradigm. And when I returned to university, I just didn't feel like I was in the right place anymore. I really couldn't see myself going down the tech route of maybe working at Google or Facebook or Apple and making a six-figure salary after a few years of being there. And this was when kind of my mental health started to spiral downhill. I was pretty depressed. You know that feeling when you wake up after a good night's sleep and you have the energy to do everything and you know exactly what needs to be done in the day. However, you just can't seem to get out of bed. And it seems like you can't find a reason to live your life that day. I don't know if you guys can relate to that, but yeah, maybe it was just me. I don't want to go into too much detail of what really triggered it, as you know, that would make the video too long, but I'm happy to make a video sharing my experience because I feel like these kinds of experiences is something that's very undershared in this space. So if this video hits 100 likes, then I'll make a part two explaining why I started entrepreneurship. And after weeks of battling my own internal dichotomy, I decided to click submit on my dropout form, thus plunging myself into £25,000 worth of debt. You see, I've always been someone that's pretty self-aware, so after I made that commitment to myself, I became pretty insanely stressed just because I understood the scope of my actions and the consequences that I would be facing. Not only am I in debt, but also I've kind of just closed the doors for many corporate jobs out there. As the older I get, the less employable I become. And if I go back to uni, obviously it's gonna impact my career prospects because it shows that I dropped out and things like that. But yeah, I just knew that I was gonna make it and I was gonna start my own business. And that's when I really committed to my agency. So going back to the original point of this video, is university worth it in 2021? Well, there's not really a one size fits all answer because it's really down to you and what you want out of your own life. One of the things I see perpetuated on social media is this almost campaign against working the 9-to-5. However, looking back at my own experience of running a business for the past year and a bit, I can tell you that there's actually a lot of appealing reasons why you would want to go down the 9-to-5 route. I can tell you with certainty that, you know, 9-to-5, you're genuinely like a lot less stressed. If you go down the entrepreneurship route, your mood and your mental health is gonna swing up and down all the time, especially in your first few years of business, when you have no idea how to manage your emotions and how to manage the ups and downs of entrepreneurship. So I genuinely believe like I'm shaving quite a few years off of my lifespan just by choosing this route. However, it's something that I'm very thankful for, but genuinely like I don't think it's for the majority of people out there. I guess the reason why I told the story earlier as opposed to just go into some lecture is because I know 70 to 90% of you out there can relate to my story in one form or another, especially if you grew up in an immigrant household. So yeah, like I genuinely believe that 80% of people in your university are there for the wrong reasons. They either are not sure what they want to do with life, or they are kind of there because their parents forced them to, or they are there under the delusion that, you know, after they graduate with the degree, they're going to be able to find a great job, and that's how they're going to be for the rest of their life, essentially. The thing I guess I really want to convey to you is, number one, university is not for everyone. Number two, a degree does not guarantee a good career. Just because, I mean, look at the situation we're in right now with the world, right? Like, COVID hit. Many of my graduate friends cannot find jobs because there's just not many opportunities out there right now. And lastly, I want you to be aware that there's many other avenues you can go down for a career to achieve financial success. So if you're only after a good career and a big paycheck, then I recommend you look elsewhere. But if you want to go into a field such as medicine or things like that, I highly recommend you actually take a gap year to really evaluate whether this is something you want to commit to and things like that. But yeah, other than that, if you want to go into law, whatever, it's really up to you, and I completely support it 100%. I don't want to be one of those people that are like, hey, it's completely useless. But the fact is, it brings a pretty negative return on investment, especially when you factor in the opportunity cost. However, to be honest, a degree is still a barrier to entry for many fields out there, and if those are the fields you want to go into, university is the only way. Thank you so much for watching this video. Have a good one.